video on Hawaii, finally. I have not been doing these, and I lived in Maui for 2.5 years. It was just months ago that I left, and you know, I've seen a lot of videos prior to going to Hawaii. I saw videos on YouTube, you know, about moving to Hawaii, living in Hawaii, visiting Hawaii. You know, you kind of want to get the lowdown about it, and so I thought I'd share with you maybe some of the less obvious things that people tell you, and you know, some obvious things too that I think are important to know. So I didn't write anything down or anything, I just wanted to shoot from the heart. The number one thing I would say people won't tell you before you go to Hawaii, and I can only speak from living in Maui, but I think this goes for all the islands, I would hope. Look up the words reverence and honor and respect, and begin to embody those words and embody their meanings and bring that with you, whether you're going to visit Hawaii for 5 days or you're selling everything and moving there like I did. There is such a lack of honor among the typical mainland culture. I'm trying to say this tactfully. And when you go to Hawaii, it's different. And especially in very specific parts, it's really important to be mindful. You know, we've kind of created this culture over here where we're kind of mindless drones on our phones, and we're looking at each other's outer surface, and we are not thinking about our history, our culture. And Hawaii has a very rich and beautiful and magical culture, and it needs to be honored. You know, people that go over there and have problems or run into problems with the locals, it's got to be because they aren't learning the proper respect and reverence while they're there. I have not met a single person who has honor and respect for the people, the culture, and the land there who had issues living in Maui. But I did meet a couple of people who had issues, and it was very obvious to me why. They weren't being present. They were trying to just be mainland, like, kind of crazy and bring it all into Maui. And it's not to say you can't have energy and have fun in Maui. Believe me, you can have some of the most intense energy. It's just you have to be very powerful with how you're being. And this might sound like a little bit of gibberish, but just stick with me here. And what I mean by that is, you know, if you go to a beach and you want to go surf, like, kind of educate yourself about the beach. Ask people, you know, is it okay for me to surf here? Is this okay? You know, if you're not a really good surfer, maybe you don't go to the really good spots, because, yeah, maybe you will get booted out. Or maybe someone will take you under their wing and kind of show you the routes, but you got to understand that there's people that have grown up there. They were born and raised there. And Hawaii is stolen land, as is so much land, but you have to understand, even though, you know, the U.S. was stolen from the Native Americans, we were born here. You weren't born in Hawaii. You weren't born there, so you're going to a place that the people from your land stole. And I'm going to link below in the description a documentary on what happened and how Hawaii got taken, and everything about the Treaty of Annexation. And it's just important to know what has happened there before you go there, so you can go there with an understanding of maybe why there is some frustration about so many people flooding to these islands, these beautiful little islands. So go with reverence and honor, please. Look up those words and see how you can embody them in your life and in your world, and especially when you go to Hawaii or any of these islands. Just, you know that there are these beautiful spaces, and they need to be honored deeply. You know, we don't need to just keep running over land and owning it and possessing it and building it and trashing it. And the next thing is, it is a small island, and that lends itself to great opportunities to make an impact. You know, anywhere that's small, you can make an impact with what you do very quickly. You can see it very quickly. So that means that if you are contributing a lot of bullshit to the landfills, and you're letting your cigarettes go on the beach or something, you are making a huge impact because you are in a very, very tiny space. Go look at the islands on the map compared to where you just came from. So Hawaii can really teach you what your impact is very quickly because you can see it. So, you know, if you're going to go there for a little while, I would recommend getting in touch with Surfrider Foundation and doing beach cleanups. They organize a lot of beach cleanups, and they usually take you out to lunch or something afterwards. But you get to go and be on the beach and clean it up, and you'll just see people bringing loads and loads of trash bags out to keep our beaches clean. And I mean, that's such a great thing to go there and want to contribute that. You want to take care of the oceans and the land there, you know. Now, something I would recommend is, if you're going to go there, you know, Hawaii is going to give you so much. It's such a rich, beautiful experience. If you can go there and look for ways that you can give back, that is, I feel like, a very respectful and honoring way to be. Slow down. I've almost got back up to mainland speed over here. I'll never get up to full speed over here because that's just no fun. You miss out on too much at the rate people go over here. But slow down. You know, if you're rushing around in your car and trying to honk and stuff, I promise you, there's a local behind you being like, "This is not the mainland, bruh." Slow down. Slow down. And that's another part of having honor and respect, is just seeing, it's different over here. Can I kind of mesh into it? Please remember that people live there and have lived there for a long time. It's not just a Disneyland playground for you. I mean, it is a fantastic playground, but that's not what it is. It is a home for many people. So you've been invited into someone's home. Act that way. Maui is a very young soil, and the energy there is very intense. Be prepared for a lot of your shit to come up if you've been holding things in. Be prepared to let it go, because Maui doesn't really put up with a whole lot of density in people. She kind of shakes it out of you. So, I mean, just coming back, when I came back, I went to Montana, and it was so easy to ground and be with the energy of Montana for me, because Maui is so intense with the energy. It's beautiful, and I crave it, and I miss it, but you really have to surrender to it to feel the ease of it. Please look, you know, again, be mindful that people live there, so don't get so distracted looking at things that you hit someone, or that you are you know, really, really going way too slow, and someone behind you is trying to get to their job, their work, because they have to work for a living. Especially on the Hana Highway, you know, that was the number one complaint when I pulled a bunch of local people. I said, you know, what is it about the tourists that's the hardest? And they said, when they're not looking, you know, it's really dangerous. Or if you're pulling off on the side of the road and there's really not enough room, but you really want to see something, you know, go a little further and walk to the place that you want to see, because it's a small place and you don't want to create a lot of hazards. You know, you're excited, you're there, you want to see things, that's wonderful. And there's a way to do it with kind of respect to everyone and everything that's going on around you. Another thing is, notice that there are other people. When you're walking around in grocery stores or anything, you know, a lot of people kind of zombie. And I'm just comparing mainland to Maui. A lot of people zombie here and don't really move out of the way. In Maui, there's like a flow. You make eye contact, you move, you flow, you communicate with people. And this is my experience. So be awake. Know that there are people around you. I mean, of all people, whenever I shop, I wear headphones, you know, because I just love to kind of dance shop. But I'm still conscious, and I feel that there's someone there, and if someone's coming in the aisle, you know, you both move over a little bit. It's just, be conscious, be honoring. And these little things might sound silly to some people, but it makes all the difference to how you're going to come off when you're there. You know, you can come off as someone who is mindful, or someone who is just still kind of in a robot mode from their lives. And I know you're going to Hawaii to probably decompress, but don't try to do everything at once. You know, enjoy your stay there, your vacation, your move, whatever it is, but ease into it, because there are plenty of spirit animals, and there are plenty of plants. And there are plenty of things there that will slow you down if you don't. I promise you, you will get spoken to through spirit, through these animals and these plants, if you are not listening. You have to listen to Maui if you're going to go there. You have to listen. Another thing is, you know, some people go and they say, well, where's the aloha? Well, you need to bring the aloha with you, and then you'll see it mirrored to you when you get to Maui. You can't just go charging in there and be like, where's the aloha? Where's it? You know, embody it yourself. Ask people about it and what it means and what it represents. You know, ask the people that have been there and held that energy for so long. Where's the aloha? It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Connect into it. Choose to connect into it. Don't just do the touristy things while you're there, because you will miss out on Hawaii. I've known people that only lived in certain parts and didn't really venture to the other parts of the island, and you're not gonna know it. I think it'd be great to, you know, instead of paying the big tourist companies or something, look online for local people who are willing to show you the island. I think that's great, because that way you're really contributing to the people of Hawaii by giving them money, and then you're getting a really authentic experience in return. And this information is not just for people that are visiting, it's for people that are moving there. You know, if you want to get acclimated and you want to get acquainted with these beautiful islands. Watch the documentary below and embrace honor and reverence and learn about the culture and go be present, and you will have an experience. And know that these islands are getting very crowded, so it's nice to go for a visit. It's good that not everybody lives there, you know? but it is magic.